Hey, everybody. We're talking the bottom line this Monday morning, and we're doing that. We're talking to Mike Jankins, of course, with Jankins Law Firm. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Sure.
Okay, so we're kind of giving everybody some warning signs today on what to look out for, maybe something that sounds familiar in their lives when they need to be calling you, correct?
Right. We're going to look at the signs of what you should be considering when to see a bankruptcy attorney. So if these things are happening in your life, you need to call me or some other bankruptcy attorney, because bad things will happen when you start seeing the list of things we're going to be going over this morning.
Yeah, kind of an alarm should be going off if any of these are starting to ring true. So let's get right into it. And this seems pretty commonplace. If you have so many credit cards, you can basically build a house of cards. That might be a sure sign.
It definitely is. So I have people come to my office and we start talking about their debts, and I ask them, well, let's take a look at your debts. And I think they took it literally, and they pull out from a box their credit cards, and they're a big stack of credit cards.
Seriously?
All banded together.
Wow.
And I've always felt if you can't fit them in your wallet and you need to have them on your money clip or whatever, you got too many.
You probably got too many debts
if you're using them all. And we'll see somebody have five or six Capital One credit cards.
Of the same kind.
And then,
oh, wow. I thought you were shopping around. And of course, he's not talking about playing cards like this. He's talking about, you know, the actual credit cards. You have so many, you could literally build something out of them.
And then they want to give them to me, and I go, no, I don't want them. It's just cut them up.
I was going to say, the next thing you should probably see is a shredder. But that's a sure sign that maybe they should be giving you a call.
It's a clear sign.
That's a dead clear sign. Okay. So that's one. Let's move on to another one. Trying to pay those credit card bills, especially if they're stacking up high each month, becomes a juggling act. I can only imagine if you can't even keep track of how many you might have, that how are you keeping track of paying those bills? And sometimes that could even feel like a three-ring circus.
Exactly. So it usually boils down to one or the other spouse has got the responsibility of paying these things. So they might both be working, or one of them's working and the other person stays home.
Right.
So that person gets the joy of getting the bills every month, and so they're opening them up going, well, okay, we'll write this one out, and oh, the money's gone, now what do I do?
Right.
So then they get paid in a couple more weeks, and well, maybe we'll pay this one, or maybe we'll pay that one. Well, there's not enough money to go around to pay all these credit card bills, so some are going to get left off, and we're going to catch those the next month, except now those are two behind, and it just starts to pile up on people when they're trying to manage all this credit card debt. It goes back to the first one. They've got so many of them, the money runs out before they get to the end of the ones you got to pay, and then they're kind of in big trouble.
Yeah.
And then they need to call me.
And yeah, start stacking up like these elephants here. And I'm glad you said the joy of opening bills. I don't think I've ever heard anybody refer to that before. All right, so the calls you get from debt collectors, that's probably another sign if you're getting those phone calls. They outnumber the calls you get from, say, hey, your spouse or even your kids. So you have numbers coming at you from all directions, but not necessarily the ones you want.
Right, so if you get these 800 numbers coming across your telephone, you already know you're not paying your bills, and the people already know, yeah, these are another debt collector calling. And so general rule is, regardless of whether you got debt problems or not, if it's an 800 number, you probably don't want to answer it, because it's probably nobody you want to really talk to.
Right.
But if you owe your bills and you're not paying them, you definitely don't want to talk to them. But when you're getting these calls, it's not because you just missed last month's payment. When you're getting these 800 calls, you probably missed 3 or 4 months now. And if you're getting lots of them, well, they keep calling over and over again the same one, but then the other ones are calling too. When you're getting all these debt collection phone calls, you need to see a bankruptcy attorney, because you're obviously not paying these bills.
Right.
That's why you're getting the phone calls. And unless something magical is going to happen in the next month or two, you better look for options on how to get that stuff taken care of one way or another, because the next step is you're going to be getting sued on these things.
Yeah.
And then you definitely need to be calling me.
A lawyer. Yeah, absolutely. Okay, so let's go back to something you touched on before, where you're not paying all of these bills. So guess what? You've run out of money. Now you're having to find it somewhere else, and that's not exactly the right solution either.
Yeah, so when you've run out of money and you don't have a part-time job to help you over the hump to take care of some of these bills, well, then people start hopping along to all the different payday loan companies around the Des Moines metro.
And we have quite a few, right?
All up and down Merle Hay Road and Douglas and Southeast 14th. They just have one shop after another, and people seem to hit them all, and they're usually getting these at $500 a pop. and they automatically start coming out of your bank account.
Right.
The next time you get paid, they're set up so when you get paid next, they get paid. And the interest rates on these payday loans are really, really bad. And so you don't have the money to pay all the credit cards anyway. So getting that payday loan that's going to hit your bank account the next time you get paid, and they're going to take all their money plus the big interest amount, then you're not going to have any more money to pay your bills. Well, then you're going back to get another payday loan to cover the bills. And again, if you're resorting to going down the street to the payday loan places because you ran out of money,
right,
the next phone call you make should be to a bankruptcy attorney.
And I'm sure they don't share information to be like, hey, don't give a loan to this guy because he's already hit us up a couple of times.
Yeah, you'd think there'd be a database or something for that, but that they'd share, but no such luck.
So let's talk about, you can't recall the last time you got an entire paycheck, maybe because all these payday loans are coming out of your check, or you're being garnished now at this point. So that pretty much means you don't have any money.
Yeah, that's right. So, I mean, my best friend, sad to say, is the wage garnishments, because finally when people get their wages garnished, they call me and go, my wages are being garnished. Can you help me?
Right.
And I go, you might need a bankruptcy. Do you have more debts than just the one wage garnishment that's going on? Well, yes, I do.
Yes, I do.
So don't wait until your wages are being garnished, which means you've already been sued by the credit card companies or the medical bills. So when you're getting sued, you already know there's bad news down the road.
Right.
Rather than have the pain of missing a quarter of your paycheck each time they garnish you, which is what they can take, quarter of your take-home pay, again, call, talk to a bankruptcy attorney, figure out what you can do. Bankruptcy may be the answer, or it may not be, but you'll have options on what you can consider rather than not having money to pay your bills.
Because that could stop the garnishments, correct?
Filing the bankruptcy will terminate the garnishments.
So that's huge.
If you want to pay your house payment, it's kind of be a big factor.
It's kind of a big deal. Okay, so let's also talk about the fact when this happens and you have no money in your wallet to pay the bills or just do the essentials in life, a lot of times that makes for not such a great situation at home. I mean, that's just the reality of things, and you don't necessarily want to be dealing with this every night as well.
Yeah, so bad finances is usually a one-way ticket to the marriage counselor, because there tends to be a lot of marital discord and stress from not being able to pay the bills. Again, one spouse is usually fielding all the phone calls and is usually having to deal with all the stress of paying the bills. And then the other spouse comes home after a hard day's work, and then they're bickering because everybody's under a lot of stress because these bills aren't getting paid. And one person wants to go, why aren't you paying the bills? And the other person's going, because we don't have the money to pay the bills.
Right.
And no one really understands because there's a lack of communication. So a lot of times no one's really talking about the family finances, which they should be, and people should understand where the finances are at each month when the bills come due. And it shouldn't be secretive where one person's paying them and crying the whole time and then doesn't even talk about it with the other spouse. And then they're not even in the loop. They don't even understand it's this bad until it all blows up. So rather than seeing a marriage counselor, see a financial counselor, a bankruptcy attorney, so that you can review your finances and try to prevent a divorce, because it's usually a big factor.
Wow, getting it back on track. So let's talk about, besides keeping the relationship alive, there's some other big purchases in your life that you probably want to keep around, especially if you're trying to get to a job so that you can make some money. Let's talk about your vehicle you just purchased. Now that's been repossessed, so you don't even have a way to get to work to make money.
Yeah, so if you ran out of money to the extent that all of a sudden you weren't paying your car payment and you missed four payments, and that's usually about what it takes, and they come and haul your car away, well, you better call a bankruptcy attorney, because if this was a late model car, you know, if it's your 2018 Chevy Malibu that just got hauled away, the odds are that you're going to get stuck for $10,000 to $12,000 of that after they sell it at the auto auction, because car dealers are buying those. They depreciate really quick within the first year.
Right.
And so people will have negative equity. They may have made a bad loan to begin with where they traded out of another car loan. And so they're going to get hammered really bad after the car sold. And for many people, the loss on that can push them over the edge. And that alone might be enough that they need to file bankruptcy. Not $15,000 in credit cards, $15,000 on an automobile repossession.
Oh, okay.
And it's not unusual. We'll have people that have two or three of these on their credit report. I don't know how they get car loans after that, but they seem to.
Unbelievable. Well, just knowing that there are companies out there that might do that, but that's not necessarily the best choice. You need to call an advisor. You need to call a bankruptcy attorney. Okay, one more. I think we can fit in here, Mike. So after paying all the credit card bills, you got that handled. there's not enough to pay the mortgage or even that car payment. So that's not necessarily a good scenario either. You know, everybody's, you know, their hands out. We need to get paid, but you can't do anything about it.
Right. So when you run out of money and you can't pay your house payment, you can't pay your car, call a bankruptcy attorney, because you can get rid of the credit card payments, you can get rid of the medical bills, instead of being homeless or being without a car and then not being able to go to your job. So if you're finding that you're running out of money, rather than go through all of the turmoil and the strife of not having a car or being
right.
homeless, and some people become homeless because of it.
Wow.
They can get evicted because they can't pay their rent,
right.
or they don't have their car. They lose their job, now they can't pay anything. So again, it's easy to pick up the phone, call a bankruptcy attorney, at least get a free consultation.
You could prevent all of this by just reaching out and saying, hey, I need some assistance. Can you help me out here? Can you see what my financial situation really
before
looks
it's
like?
Too late.
Before it's too late. How do you do that? Well, you can go online. It's as simple as that. iowa-bankruptcylaw.com. Of course, people can always reach out to you by giving you a call as well, 515-255-1855, and they can send you an email as well. But don't wait until it's too late to make that connection.
That's right.
Okay, now that's just the tip of the iceberg of some of the signs. Next time you come and visit us here at Iowa Live, we're going to talk even more about those signs that might trigger saying, hey, I need to give you a call.
Unfortunately, there's many more.
There's a lot more out there. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. That's the bottom line, everybody. Reach out to an expert so you don't get caught in any of these tragic scenarios.